debate number one at 9 p.m. tonight in the News Hour. We've got GVL Narasimha Rao and Prafulla Ketkar on one side. On the other side, we've got Waris Pathan, who will be joining us in a bit. Alimuddin Khan continues to be with us today as well. Clyde Craster is with us in the studio. And Rajiv Rai of the Samajwadi Party. Now, just before we begin the debate, just a very quick mention for our viewers also. Prime Minister met President Pranab Mukherjee just a short while ago. We'll try and play out that picture also for you of that meeting. He's met the President, of course, over the demonetization decision and the implementation that is now being carried out by the government. And he also briefed the President, we understand, on the government's efforts. So that's the latest that we've got on black money. But getting back to the debate, what's happening in the Parliament? Now, I want to begin with some of our politicians from the opposition, and perhaps Clyde, you could take it first, and then we'll go across to Rajiv Rai as well. What we saw in the Parliament today was just a lot of yelling, a lot of ruckus created back and forth, primarily between the Congress Party and the government leaders. Don't you think that we've lost the focus of what the agenda is? We are not even talking about black money, demonetization or its implementation anymore. It's become more about what Ghulam Nabi Azad has said, what the government is doing, whether the Prime Minister should come into the Parliament or not. Where's the focus? Have we lost the focus here, Clyde?
Well, that's what the BJP is doing. No, they are asking him to say sorry, they ask him to apologize, and you know, things like that. So I think they are not focusing on the right issue. The question that have been raised in the Parliament, they need to give the answers. So instead of giving answers, they're trying to create a ruckus. Actually, they are trying to divert and subvert the whole issue and go into some other level.
That's now, one second. What's the bone of contention? Is it the fact that the Prime Minister should be there in Parliament, or is it the issue of demonetization? What's the bone of contention? You wanted a debate. A debate is going on now, but you don't want that debate to continue because you want the Prime Minister to be inside Parliament.
Well, the Prime Minister has to be there.
What is the bone of contention? The Prime Minister being in Parliament or the issue of demonetization?
Both. He has to be there to discuss the whole demonetization issue. See, my party has always welcomed the fact that, you know, this had to be done. We had to flush out black money, you know, and we have to make sure that, you know, the system works in a very systematic manner.
But the point here is
that the government did not plan this from day one. They have not
What the Congress party has, I know you're from the NCP, but what the Congress has successfully done is distract the debate from demonetization itself and make it one about religion by dragging in the identity of Ghulam Nabi Azad, make it about nationalism. It's not about nationalism. Clyde Craster, the opposition has it wrong, but I want to put this question to Alimuddin Khan, who leans towards the Congress Party. He's a political analyst, but leans towards the Congress Party. Alimuddin Khan, yesterday you were here on this debate when we debated what Ghulam Nabi Azad had said, but today, a third day in Parliament washed out. What is the strategy of the Congress Party?
Niranjan ji, you see, the decision was taken by one person, Prime Minister himself, what we doubt, without taking his cabinet in the consideration for the demonetization.
How do you know that?
Now, that person
how do you
is
know
missing
that? No,
from the
Ali
Parliament.
Khan, when you make a charge on the News Hour, you should also substantiate that. Now, you're wildly throwing an allegation that the Prime Minister unilaterally took a decision. What's the proof? If you're making a comment on the News Hour, please substantiate that.
You see, Niranjan ji, they have leaked a limited information to their BJP state units.
Okay, do you have proof of that? Okay, Alimuddin Khan, stop right there. Second wild allegation, do you have proof of that? Alimuddin Khan, one second, do you have proof of that?
Niranjan.
GVL.
The Congress has to first make up its mind. Either they can say that nobody knew except the Prime Minister. They cannot give a confused statement. On the one hand, they say a lot of people knew about it, and now they say nobody knew about it. So which statement is correct?
Yes.
Which statement do you want to back?
Exactly.
Please come clean on this.
They seem to be trying to grab onto something to confront the government with, which is why I'm bringing up this point. And we've got Waris Pathan also now with us on this debate. But Waris Pathan, before I come to you, same question that I asked Clyde, going across to Rajiv Rai. Rajiv Rai, don't you think the Congress is actually hijacking the whole debate on black money and demonetization? We're not even talking about the actual issues. Clyde here mentioned that the problem is with implementation, that whether the government had planned or not planned. Who's talking about it anymore? Everybody's talking about Prime Minister to be there or not. Everybody's talking about what Ghulam Nabi Abbas. No, nobody is.
Everybody.
No, you have allowed the Congress party to take the decision that this is supposed to be about what Ghulam Nabi Azad wants to say.
What you said, nobody's talking about it. The common man is talking about it every day. He's having sleepless nights.
Why are you not talking about it in the Parliament? You just saw the highlights of what happened in the Parliament today. Both the houses.
You say nobody's talking about it. Don't make a judgment.
I am. Because you know what, Clyde? You all talk about a united opposition. But you know what has happened today? Both the houses were adjourned by afternoon.
The common man is talking about it.
Common man is.
Everybody's talking about it.
We are. Politicians in the parliament are not. In the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha. You are here talking about it. What did the opposition discuss in the parliament today?
In Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha.
Yes.
But don't make a judgmental statement that nobody is talking about
that
it.
That is my point. You are allowing Congress to take charge. Rajiv Rai, you want to come into this? Why is it that the discussion has become about what Ghulam Nabi Azad said, what he meant, then politicizing and communalizing it furthermore, and the government then demanding for an apology? I didn't hear anything about the actual demonetization implementation today. And both the houses were adjourned by afternoon, Rajiv Rai. Aren't you upset that as a united opposition, you've not been able to steer the debate in the right direction?
See, to be very honest and frank, it's very unfortunate if parliament does not function in order for the reason it has been assembled there. But the onus lies with the ruling party. Onus lies with the ruling party to take house in the confidence. I don't understand, as a common man, as a citizen of this country, I fail to understand. Very next day of demonetization, Prime Minister can go to Japan, make fun of the poor. Gharo mein saati hai, lekin paisa nahi hai. Conveniently, he can keep silent on his party leader, Mr. Jonathan Levis Maris, and he cannot go to the parliament. What is wrong? If that is the bone of contention,
no, I don't think the government has ruled that out.
Why BJP is making such a
Rajiv Rai, just a fact
why
check.
Why BJP is
Rajiv Rai, Rajiv Rai, just a quick fact check there. I don't think the government has ruled out the Prime Minister being in parliament. He's been in and out. If I'm not wrong, GVL, I think you can answer him on that one. The Prime Minister has been in and out, and I don't think they've completely
the Prime
ruled
Minister,
out. Yeah, they've not completely ruled
Prime
out
Minister,
one. And secondly, they're asking for the apology of what Ghulam Nabi Azad said.
I didn't say he's completely ruled out.
So where is the basic demand?
The
Prime Minister has to sit through an entire debate.
That is the least demand. He can acknowledge the opposition. He can acknowledge the
there a convention?
What is the big deal?
Is there a convention that Prime Minister has to sit throughout the debate in any House of Parliament? I think the convention is the concerned minister replies to a motion of debate. And here you have not even waited for the government to make its position clear.
Absolutely.
Because you don't have anything to debate. The problem is opposition is completely bereft of ideas.
Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad's statement was expunged from the record.
You are bankrupt.
On the record. Then why you are making issue that he should apologize? Anyhow, this statement has been expunged.
What are you interested in? Are you interested in a debate?
No, you want to discuss on day one.
We were prepared to take up a discussion in Lok Sabha. It's the opposition parties which are looking for excuses not to debate. Because they have nothing to say.
Yeah.
They have done outside the house. They don't have issues to debate. They're completely bankrupt.
that this country wants to know.
Political bankruptcy of opposition.
Cannot take refuge of Congress doing this.
Created excuses. Possibly even Gulam
Azad's
comments were meant to derail the debate.
And allow the parliament to function. The onus is with you. Onus is with you. A little bit compromise. Take the position in confidence. Run the house smoothly. Come out clean.
GVL, let me ask him a question. Rajiv Rai, let me ask you a question. Because you are questioning the government, and I know what your party's position is. You're questioning the implementation, but you don't have an issue with the move of demonetization itself. Let me ask you a simple question. Does the Samajwadi Party back what Gulam Nabi Azad said? Yesterday, your party spokesperson said, no, we don't completely agree with that. Today, I'm asking you, do you agree or disagree with what Gulam Nabi Azad said?
Not at all.
So you don't agree with that statement, right?
Not at all.
So do you think Rajiv Rai, do you think the Congress party must take that back? Rajiv Rai, a follow up question. Do you think the Congress party must take that back instead of defending it and taking it to the next level? Do you think the Congress party must take that back?
I agree to the extent both the BJP and Congress. The BJP should not insist for apology and Congress.
I'll tell you what is happening.
What about Akhilesh Yadav? Akhilesh Yadav said black economy is good for the country. Black money sustains this country. We should encourage black money.
Akhilesh
Yadav is talking about parallel economy.
Okay, that was outside the parliament. Now, GVL, what we want to focus on is what gets discussed. GVL and Rajiv Rai, we want to focus on what gets discussed, or rather, in this case, what is not getting discussed in the parliament. 1 minute, both of you gentlemen, please.
Lying, making country fool.
The point here is
nobody can beat you.
That the political parties, GVL and Rajiv Rai, 1 minute. You are taking the debate again in a direction that it shouldn't be going. This is exactly what is happening in both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Let's not do this here on the News Hour, please. The point here is that the debate is slipping out of the hands of all political parties. For example, there was a comment made. Yes, 1 minute, Mr. Rajiv Rai. Listen to me and then you can come in. Yesterday, the comment that was made by Gulam Nabi Azad, it's been expunged from the record of the parliament, but outside he's come and backed it. Today, the entire day, the Congress party has gone ahead and brazened it out, saying, yes, that is what it is. We are not going to apologize. There is nothing wrong. You know what else? This is how the debate is being hijacked, and this should be a problem for every political party. Today, Manish Tiwari told us that BJP is up to its old tricks of abusing and confusing people. Fundamentally, the BJP has no answers to this illegal demonetization. So therefore, in order to subvert the entire issue, they are playing up bogeys. Gulam Nabi Azad has been the chief minister of J&K. Mr. Azad is one of those people who's been at the forefront of the fight against terror in the last 2.5 decades and has personally suffered at the hands of terror. So therefore, BJP wants to question his credentials because he's a Muslim. And Mr. Azad happens to be a Muslim, and that Muslim are the easiest targets. I'm sorry. What is it that Manish Tiwari and the Congress are trying to do here? Now you're trying to communalize the issue?
Bogey.
What is the connection? What is the connection of the religious identity of any politician to what is happening about demonetization and black money? Alimuddin Khan, where is the Congress party taking this entire debate? They're hijacking it. The other opposition parties may have constructive points, but nobody is able to give those points because this is what your party is doing inside and outside the house. Not your party, but the party that you lean towards, Alimuddin Khan.
Tanvi ji, if you give me time, I'll reply it. If a common man like me on 8th November on your channel can see that how there will be a chaos in the country, how farmers of this country will suffer, how marriages of this country will be disturbed, how people will commit suicide or die due to other reasons, 55 people have died so far.
And I agree with you. And those are the points, Alimuddin Khan, that should have been discussed in the parliament and outside. Then why is it that the political party is communalizing it and speaking about terror attacks and comparing it to an economic policy?
Let me speak, please. Tanviji,
you're not answering my question, Mr. Khan.
The economic banking mismanagement of this government has pushed the country into the depression, economic depression. Trading is failed.
So you have put this country into an economic mess for 60 years, and you think everybody else is doing, everyone else is destroying it. You have put it into a mess for 60 years. We are trying to reform the economy. The mess that you have created, we are trying to clear the mess. This is Swachh Bharat. People are backing this move. I think you are still wanting to sustain your black politics. Not just sustain black economy. And you are not wanting a frontal attack on corruption.
Alimuddin Khan,
because and Rahul Gandhi, Congress GVL, party, are GVL, simply GVL, wanting to sustain GVL. The black deeds of Congress rule.
I'll answer you. You see, if you say 55 people died, even Prime Minister's brotherly man, Chaiwala, 62-year-old Chaiwala, also died.
Alimuddin Khan, I asked you, what was the question? What was the question asked to you? Alimuddin Khan, what was the question asked to you? I think, let me remind you about the, every time a question is asked to you.
Who is responsible for this?
Alimuddin Khan, what was the question asked to you?
Yes, Niranjan ji.
What was the question asked to you? You know what? Supreme Court.
Who is responsible for all the scams that you have carried out?
GVL, one second.
You have killed the economy of this country.
Yeah, GVL, one second.
You have created a culture of corruption.
GVL, what was the question asked to Alimuddin Khan? The question asked was, why bring in religion to the demonetization debate? Right? Alimuddin Khan, one second, you haven't been able to answer any of the questions. I want to bring in Waris Pathan at this point. Waris Pathan, I want to, let me ask you this question, Waris Pathan. It started off as criticism for the demonetization policy, right? It degenerated when the Uri attacks were dragged in and casualties were compared to Uri attacks and to what's happened post demonetization, right? What is the core debate? Is the core debate about the merits and demerits of demonetization, or is it about Uri attacks and religion? Waris Pathan. Come to the point, Waris Pathan.
Let me tell you one thing, Niranjan. First of all, I'm coming to the point, Niranjan. Just give me 30 seconds and let me complete my points. The first thing I want to make it clear is everybody is against the black money. Everybody is against corruption. Nobody supports black money and corruption. But the way the government of the day has made this demonetization thing is totally, I would say, there was no logic. There was no policy. They were not prepared for it. I will tell you, we are debating here in the studio and sitting and talking. I would like Mr. GVL and I would like a cabinet minister from his party to accompany me. Come to any bank in Mumbai, Baikala, Dadar, Shivaji Park, anywhere, and see what the apathy is being faced by the people who are standing in the queue.
Waris.
See, this Waris. Is not the black money.
It
is my money which I have put in the bank and I am not able to take out the money. And
come
see,
to Delhi,
this is a classic.
I will show you how crowds have reduced in
GVL.
Done
how
by the government of the day on the
done.
Poor people of
Waris
the country.
GVL.
In about half an hour.
Waris
in
and GVL.
Bank.
Waris and GVL.
Come to
Mr.
Delhi.
Niranjan,
I'll take you.
This is a,
I'll take you
Waris,
to a bank branch.
No, Mr. GVL.
Waris, what was the question I asked you? Waris, what you're making?
Come with me.
What you're saying is a valid point. You're making a valid point. Waris, you're making a valid point. I'm not disagreeing with you. One second. Pull back. What am I telling you? I'm saying you have a valid point. And I'm going to question the BJP on that, because even the Supreme Court has spoken about it. The Calcutta High Court has spoken about it. Yes, the courts have spoken about it. I'm going to ask the BJP.
Yes.
What is the question I asked you? What does religion have to do? What is the identity of a politician? What does the Uri attacks have to do with it? And the reason I'm asking you that question is because this is the one reason why the parliament is deadlocked. I'm asking you, Waris Pathan, what does religion and the identity of Ghulam Nabi Azad have to do with the debate?
See, the
or the Uri attacks?
I am not the spokesperson for the Congress nor for the BJP. But the demonetization that is done by the government of the day is a classic example of surgical strike committed by the BJP government on the poor people of the nation. Today, everybody is in trouble. You ask a person, there is a marriage in his household. And you, Mr. Niranjan, if I want to get my daughter married, what will I do in 2.5 lakh rupees?
Yes. And
my
like
money
Niranjan
is there
said,
in the bank.
Point
I'm
taken.
A taxpayer.
Why is
I need
point
account
taken?
To the income tax department. Why and don't they allow me to remove the money from the
point
bank?
Point taken, and we are going to
and
raise some of those issues and ask the BJP spokesperson
come
on it. But very quickly, some of the other panelists want to come in, and I think Prafulla Ketkar Yes, we're very quickly going across to Prafulla Ketkar. He's been wanting to make a point for a bit, and Clyde will come to you after that. But Prafulla, first to you. You wanted to make a point to what Varis was saying.
Yeah. See, there seems to be a complete confusion among the opposition parties. They started with saying that we are against black money and we will come this decision. Then they said, you know, some of the people from BJP knew about it. Then they started talking about the poor people. But ultimately, the signal they are giving to the common people that they are actually favoring the black money. See, no one can deny the fact that this has been a big blow on the black money generation. In India.
No, sir, please.
See, come with me.
Let me complete.
I didn't disturb you. I have visited more banks than you. Please.
I have visited more banks than you.
I have spoken to more people than you. Don't disturb. I didn't disturb you.
Allow them to use the money, sir.
Please don't speak over each other.
No opposition party. Yes, absolutely. So the real issue is, implementation part. You should come with a constructive discussion.
Yes.
You should come with constructive suggestion.
No. Yes.
This is our common responsibility.
We will go to that. We will go to that point.
Instead of criticizing the demonetization decision, you should speak about the implementation part of it.
Take back the decision.
Exactly. Instead, what's happened? You speak about implementation.
You debate implementation.
There was an element of secrecy in it.
Prafulla Ketkar, what is the question we're asking? This question is to you. Prafulla Ketkar talking about? He's saying debate implementation. For 3 days, the parliament has been on. First day, you had some solid debating in parliament.
That's the problem. They want to question the demonetization.
Why shouldn't
Kejriwal has openly said this.
Yeah, got it. Prafulla, I got that. But what are we questioning? We are questioning the intent and the direction which the debate has taken, right? Because the moment you dragged in Uri attacks, the moment you spoke about religion, why shouldn't we ask the relevant question if there is an attempt to communalize the argument and distract from the real argument?
Because Congress party knows very well that it has lost the power on the issue of corruption. The moment they start discussing this issue seriously and they get the answers from the government, they will lose the plot. They will hand it over to Mamata Banerjee and Kejriwal. So they have no option but to divert the issue. The reality is they don't want black money to be eradicated. They are in a big soup. There are coming elections. Everybody knows that how elections are fought in India.
So let's try and do something here.
All these issues are linked up.
Point taken. Prafulla, let's try and do something else here.
The point that we are trying to drive at is
to say that this has to be a constructive debate, and all the political parties must, as representatives of people in the parliament, both upper house and lower house, come with constructive points. They've not been able to do that, or at least majoritily. So let's try and do that here. Maybe set an example for some of those netas who may be watching this show. And I want to start by coming to GVL and putting this question, and then all of you can add with your points on it. But GVL, is there a research internal survey preparation that the government or the BJP have done on the kind of short-term impact, not long-term? Nobody is questioning the kind of long-term impact it will have if black money is out of the system. But in short term, what is the impact on economy, on your auto rickshaw drivers, on your traders, on your jewelers, on your vegetable sellers, on your small time businessmen, or what is the impact? Do you have any numbers? There are a lot of numbers that are coming out in the media, and I'm going to quote some of them. But I first want to know from you if there is any validated numbers that you can give us.
No, Tanvi, when a decision of this nature is taken, I'm sure there are very few people that were involved in a discussion on this. It could not have been a large deliberation involving hundreds of people. Certainly, it would have been done by a very small group of well-informed people, and it wouldn't have gone beyond that at all. So certainly, you would not have the time, you would not be able to carry out a large-scale survey.
GVL, that can't be the excuse. What is the impact in short term on the economy and long term for the entire country? has to be something that must have been factored in, GVL. I don't know if you've been briefed about it or factored in. But there has to be. How can you be unprepared for the kind of impact there will be? Otherwise, how do you deal with it?
I'll tell you how unprepared they are.
Yes.
It couldn't have been done. I'm saying it couldn't have been done involving hundreds of people.
But definitely the top ministers, the prime minister, finance ministers, advisors.
No, certainly a very close-knit group of people would have done the assessment, and certainly we are the fastest growing economy.
Okay, Clyde, you want to take that up? Okay, GVL, I asked you because I have some numbers here. GVL.
Certainly after assessing.
This has come in the newspapers. Individually have sources. So we are not going to say that we can individually confirm these this kind of a data. But just in Mumbai, the taxis business is down by 25%. That's the source of the Mumbai Taximen's Union. Retail business, as per the Retail Traders Association, since the announcement was made, after that for 9 working days, retail business down by 50%. Autos business down by 27%. All of this is expected because people don't have the cash. The octroi business, of course, will be hit. Restaurants, jewelers, daily wagers, property. These are individual data that Mumbai Mirror has quoted from sources and put out. Now, Clyde, are you seeing on ground?
Is there an impact? Let me tell you why this impact
Sanvi,
is.
For a few days. You see, it doesn't mean...
Jeevel, just let him make a point and you can respond to that.
How do you define a short term? What is short term for you?
No, I'll tell you what the long term is.
This is just the beginning.
I'll tell you what the long term is.
This is just the beginning, GVL. We don't even know how long the cash crunch is going to last. Yes.
I'll explain to you. Now, allow me to finish. This is what I read also.
No, things have started easing up.
No,
things are not the same as they were 10 days ago.
Okay, GVL, just let others make a point. You can rebut all of them together.
See, you know, I'll tell you something. See how unplanned these people are. You know, by stopping this 86% of the currency, they've suddenly declared 14 trillion rupees as illegal tender. Okay, now you need to bring that back into the system. Now to do that, we have 4 mints in Karnataka, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and West Bengal. Now these 4 mints, even if you divide the 500 rupee notes and the 2000 rupee notes, these 4 mints have to collectively print 17.5 billion notes.
Yes.
17.5 billion notes. And collectively, they can only print... 1 minute, let me finish. They can only print 3 billion notes per month. That makes it 6 months get these notes down. Assuming that they have started printing 3 months back, that still leaves 3 months to go. That means what 50 days was asked does not work. What was said today by Mr. Venkaiah Naidu that in 10 days everything will be all right, that's not work. And one more.
I got your point.
The second part is all that money has to be sent to 19 Reserve Bank of India. From there to the banks.
GVL. Okay, let me put that question. I understood your question. In fact, I want to add to that. And my point is, GVL, you know, the government has been consistently maintaining that the preparation for demonetization, for withdrawing the 500 and 1000 rupee notes has been on for 6 months now. 6 months. Just one quick fact, and this has been asked, it's a very, very relevant question. If the RBI governor took over only in September, and we know that the new notes are being printed only from September, that's 2 months ago, exactly two months after he took over, the new notes began rolling out. So if that was the case, on what basis are we saying that the preparation has been on for 6 months when you know there's not enough new currency
in
the market?
No, there's duplicity and a doubt
in the system.
We was 6 months the thing.
Let him answer. You put the question. GVL,
GVL, go ahead. No one should disturb me. I'll give a very quick reply.
Okay.
You see, when you say preparation was on, so if you had really printed notes for 6 months, you would have really, from next day, you would have had all the supply in hand. But by doing so much of preparation, the news would have been out well in advance.
Okay.
You would, the very purpose of this exercise, to catch all the hoarders off guard.
To strike at all the terror funding.
It would have come to a knot. I think you had to start, you could not start your real work until you took that decision and started implementing it.
Yeah,
so 6 months ago, I think if, no, no, it, my idea may have occurred and you must have started discussing it in a very small
small group. GVL, the moment you start printing and distributing to all the banks and recalibrating all the ATMs,
GVL, there are reports
the whole
from March
world
of this
would
year.
Have known about it.
GVL, because you raised that point, I want to put it on record. Since March this year, since March 2016, you can go back and you can check. There are reports of the government's move or a planned move 2000. To replace the 500 and 1000 rupee notes. So the news is out there. So you can't say that the government may have been thinking about it. It was out in the media. You go out and you go out. Niranjan, just do a quick Google search. Let me tell you, just do a quick Google search.
No, Niranjan,
in the search section, customize
Niranjan,
it.
Niranjan, I think please grant. See, please grant some intelligence to the government. You see, can I have a say? No, please let me say. I think there are a lot of media reports. You should allow a viewpoint to emerge from our side as well.
Yes, yeah. Please. We would love to hear more from the government.
What you grant some intelligence to the government.
Niranjan,
because if these Niranjan, printing Niranjan, presses were going at Niranjan, a 50% or a 40% capacity utilization, all these notes could have been printed well in advance and kept ready for circulation. But the ones you have done that, more and more people would have known about it. The amount of currency printed, it would have leaked and people would have known all this currency is going to be replaced.
Okay.
So there is a trade-off.
Okay, agreed. Also, we don't know a lot of this data.
Secrecy,
lot of this data is still unverified because the government won't come out and give, validate any of this data.
Can I come in, please?
Yes, Alimuddin Khan. Go ahead.
Quickly, 30 seconds, Alimuddin Khan. Quickly.
Survey was done for the UP elections. That when they come to know that BJP is losing in UP, number one, that surgical strikes, they hijack.
Media reports say we are winning. Where do you live?
Job failed.
Do you live in India
now,
or somewhere else?
Now RSS
work, Indian
RSS,
media surveys
RSS,
have shown
RSS
that we are
failed.
We are number
now,
one party in UP.
What they
winning
did
about 180
now they are promoting a
our internal
person.
Survey showed we
they
were winning
survive
more than 250.
Okay. 1 minute.
I don't know. One second. Everything doesn't have to be linked. One second. Don't see a grand conspiracy behind everything. Alimuddin Khan.
The person is very demanding.
Alimuddin Khan.
Very dictatorial.
Okay, you know what? Alimuddin Khan. Please don't see a grand conspiracy. Conspiracy behind everything. Don't see a grand conspiracy because even we have reasons to believe.
Niranjan,
and even
can
we can clear, you know, even we
Niranjan,
can ask you the
can
question
can
because
in?
Yeah, Waris Pathan, I'll come to you one second. I want to make a point to Alimuddin Khan because he talks about a grand conspiracy.
See,
that's why the Congress. Why shouldn't we question the Congress party and their intent when they brought in Uri attacks and religion into the debate?
Right.
Because even then you're trying to communalize that case. So why should we ask you that question?
First argument that people are suffering and people are against this move. Then BJP has dug its own grave.
Yeah.
He should be happy about that.
Yeah.
On the one hand, he's saying that people are happy.
If you're questioning the implementation,
on the other hand,
he's
saying that it was done
on the ground
to tackle the UP election.
Yeah. So why don't you wait for the election? Why is he claiming that it's all in the election?
What kind of allegations and arguments is making?
Today, GVL is saying that they were unprepared. GVL said they were unprepared.
You have a difficulty
in
understanding what
is
said.
You have to
make a decision without.
No, Alimuddin Khan, I don't think.
For the purpose of, for the sake of confidentiality,
which have thrown country into
greater the preparation, lesser would have been the secrecy. Greater the preparation, lesser would have been the confidentiality.
When people storm into the parliament because of the economic depression. What you are doing in this
Alimuddin
country?
Khan, one second, I'm asking him that question, right? So just hold on one second.
You are politically
GVL.
And financially bankrupt.
GVL,
there is
second.
No depression and there
GVL,
is no,
to my
no sign of it.
GVL, to take forward
you
what we've been asking
villages,
some relevant questions.
Go to villages, please.
Alimuddin Khan, that's the question I'm trying to ask GVL. Please
people
be
are dying.
Please
why
be patient.
People have died.
GVL,
why you have changed? Why
Alimuddin
you have,
Khan,
why
please
you
be
have
patient and listen to the question.
You have decision in 9
yeah,
days.
Yeah, I'm trying to put that question to him, please.
Niranjan
Alimuddin Khan, one
government
second.
Government has changed 18 times their decision
you have
in
to
9
stop.
Days.
Let me ask the question. Alimuddin Khan.
Total confusion.
Waris, you can respond. Waris, you can respond to GVL after I ask him this question.
Many of those dates have nothing to do with demonetization.
Prafulla Kedkar, I have a question for the BJP right now. Please, one second.
I want
And you know, Mr. I'm asking GVL. You this question because GVL, you know, we quoted some facts to you. We put some facts out there. Some of the numbers being projected by the media. But it's not just the media that is asking you questions. Supreme Court of India. What did the Supreme Court of India say today, the 18th of November?
Supreme Court has warned. In fact, this is what exactly what Arvind Kejriwal and Mamata Banerjee have been saying on the streets of Delhi for the last couple of days. Supreme Court has warned that they, quote unquote, may be riots, in the words of the Supreme Court, and refused your government's plea to stay cases filed against demonetization in high courts and lower courts across the country. Supreme Court added, saying, how can we shut our doors to people when there is a problem of such magnitude? Chief Justice of India noted that people have started becoming frantic, right, quote unquote, frantic for money.
Mr. Niranjan, I want to make a
one
point
second.
Here.
Let me complete. Let me complete, Waris. And the Supreme Court, you know, the Chief Justice of India has also said the problem is of serious magnitude. I am asking you because Venkaiah Naidu, the Information and Broadcasting Minister, has also said that the common man is happy.
Who is he listening to?
Let him answer. Question is to GVL.
Yeah, Niranjan.
Yeah,
Niranjan, I do not want to comment on the observations of the Honorable Supreme Court, but certainly compared to the situation on the 10th of November, situation has eased to a great extent, at least in the urban areas, and also in the course of next week or 10 days. I think things will stabilize even in rural areas. So certainly, we don't see any such situation emerging.
No.
And the government is doing everything possible to ensure that problems do not...
I understand if you want to allay the fears of people, but you and the government needs to be a lot more aware of what's really happening on ground and to what extent it has improved. Like he quoted the
Sanvi,
Supreme Court, there
I
are petitions now in the Calcutta High Court, GVL, and at some
party,
point you will have to go
of,
yes you will have
of,
to go to these courtrooms, the government will have to go and respond. And you know, the answers
so
that you give to the political parties in the parliament or outside are not going to work. You will have to give actual proof. Now, I could see Prafulla also trying to make a point there. Waris Pathan, you had a question. You
so
go
Sanvi,
first. And Prafulla Ketkar may want to add to that.
Mr.
Yes,
GVL. GVL.
Just listen to Waris
yeah,
Pathan also has to say. Prafulla Ketkar was shaking his head in between. I want to know what that head shake was about. Yes, Waris Pathan first.
Government will
give me 30 seconds. Let me put my point, Mr. GVL, when you said that the government was not prepared, then why did the government say it? Firstly, that only 30 days will be given to you till 30th December. Only 50 days will be given to you. When the government knew that 7 months will be required for the show. 7 months
no,
are required.
Again,
there are only four
minting
places
this
in our country.
Was made earlier.
And it will require
no,
6 months
you
for them.
You are not required to replace
and now I will,
all
no, no, no.
the currency.
Kindly listen to my questions
I think,
and then you
on.
Can revert.
I
now how do I give?
No, I have understood the question.
How
this
do
was
I
mentioned
give?
Even earlier.
1%
you
of the people in our country are using credit
currency.
Card, Mr. GVL. Or hardly 1% of the people are
no,
using
I think you
credit
want to make political
country.
Points
the
or you want
country
to also
uses
get a
cash.
Don't speak
now,
over
if
each
a person
other. Don't speak over
make,
each other. One second.
No, if I want,
what is,
if what I
is you said you had a question. Ask your question. Complete your question.
People,
let,
how will I give the salary?
What's your question?
How would a person give salary to
no,
the staff who is working under him?
Niranjan.
The people will not take a check.
Are you making
the driver will not take a check. The grocery shop is not taking a check. In Maharashtra, if you go to a theater, you can buy a ticket for the earlier notes, but a farmer who is waiting on the streets to sell his vegetables does not have
what
the
is your question?
Money.
Yes, yes.
Question.
Okay, so in Maharashtra, agreed point taken, Waris Pathan. I don't think there's a question there, but the point you were making was that the relief came in for movie watchers. I got it. The relief came in for movie watchers before the relief came in for the farmers. Yes, Clyde, I'll come to you. Just 1 minute. Prafulla Ketkar has been sitting there very silently and shaking his head about something. I want to hear what he has to say.
You take on Prafulla Ketkar.
Yes.
You take on Prafulla Ketkar. 1 second. Let you take on profit.
Yes,
yes. What Mr. Jivinath now said about the rural areas, right?
The point I agree with the implementation issues.
Yes.
He's
please,
agreeing.
Please, please.
He's with the RSS and he's agreeing.
No, I'm talking
yes.
about no, I'm talking about the rural areas, the farmers.
He's talking exactly
okay.
about that.
Please.
So let him speak
okay.
and you respond
okay.
to it. Yeah, Prafulla, go on.
No, I'm not RSS. I'm not speaking on behalf of RSS.
I said you lean towards
I will
RSS,
tell you a
yeah.
couple of experiences.
Yeah.
What a bank manager said in one of the banks, private banks. He said, if the dummy people do not stand in the line, there is no pressure on us.
A poor person told me that if, thanks to Modi ji, my daughter's marriage is going off well in a small budget. These are the reactions. So don't
look at both sides of the reaction. Look at both sides of the reaction.
There are certain issues about the supply of currency.
Yes.
There are these are also reactions.
Yeah, so these others are also reactions.
There are issues related to supply of currency. And we need to address it collectively. This is a testing time for us as a nation, and not only political parties, media, social organization, everybody of us have to behave responsibly in this situation. Otherwise, we will miss an opportunity to clean the system once and for all.
You want to add to that? What's the constructive point you want to make?
No, I want his reaction on this behavior. When you talk about rural areas, we are talking about farmers. Cooperative banks are shut. The farmers rely on cooperative banks. Now today, he cannot sell his wares. He cannot sell his vegetables or fruit because nobody is buying. Nobody has cash. So that's a dead stop. No, let me finish now.
Let me finish my point.
The farmer has a dead stock that he cannot sell. Now the next season comes in where he has to plant his seeds. He has no money to buy the seeds. So where is he now? Now you're saying you're giving 50,000 rupees for farmers to withdraw, but if the bank is shut, if the cooperative banks are shut, where is he going to get the money from? You are talking about the rural areas, you are talking about villages,
let's debate
about
this.
Farmers,
because
but look
this,
at the apathy
let's
of the
debate
farmers
this.
Like this.
This is a crucial problem. There were a series of announcements made by the government yesterday. Let's see if our panelists agree whether that is
every
helpful
day
or not. There's
decision.
More to be done. Prafulla Ketkar, you want to respond to what Clyde just said here?
Are the measures adding to the confusion? Are the new measures showing that the government is not really sure and each day coming up with new steps to somehow tackle the situation? Prafulla, I think that's
so
the point.
Today one more decision was said that at the petrol pumps you can get money.
Yes.
You can swipe your card and get money. Which petrol pump? Then they write it selective, but which selective petrol pump? You go to any petrol pump in Mumbai. I have not gone to all. We're going to be very honest about it. But the few petrol pumps I went, there was no dispense.
Yeah.
So you just give out statements, but nothing just for talking to people saying that we are taking care of you, but there's no practicality.
Okay, that aspect, GVL can respond to it, but Prafulla Ketkar, you want to take the one about what's happening in our villages and the rural outreach and cooperative banking. Yes. Go ahead.
See, the issue really is people are panic about changing the notes.
Yes.
And in turn, we are facing shortage of currency.
True.
If we manage these two things separately, many things will be sorted out. The problem is nobody want to...
Yeah, the problem is that you don't want to sort out. No, the problem is...
They want to make political allegations. They want to make communalized.
The problem is you don't want to sort it out.
No, no.
That's the problem is you don't want to sort it out. Because in Parliament, I'm sorting it out. You're not sorting it out in Parliament.
No, one second. I'm trying to talk to you.
My question is to Rajiv Rai.
I'll give you a valid point. You know, there's
fear. No, you made a point.
No, there's a fear.
You made a point.
That they withdraw 2,000 rupees. People fear that they go out to shop at 2,000 rupees. The shopkeeper says... You
point
exhaust
taken,
the full money.
No,
that's what the fear
no,
is.
Got
exactly
that.
The point. Why is this not
measures?
Being debated in the parliament?
Exactly. And why aren't you debating in the parliament? Varis, hold back. I have to bring in Rajiv Rai because he's been patiently sitting there for some time. Rajiv Rai.
No, in the parliament that...
Rajiv, one second. Varis Pathan, hold on. I'll bring you in. I'll give you your say in just a few seconds from now. Rajiv Rai, you tell me. What is the Congress party and the opposition stand? You want the Prime Minister to be in Parliament. But you tell me, why can't answers be given to pressing questions without the Prime Minister being in Parliament? If you say the issue is urgent, needs to be addressed immediately, why don't you debate minus the Prime Minister and get the relevant answers from the government and the ministers concerned inside Parliament? Why is the opposition adamant on the Prime Minister being inside?
See, I'm not a spokesperson for the Congress. Let me.
I said opposition.
No. Yes. As a opposition, we are for the debate and discussion in the Parliament. But having said so, allow me to have two questions. One thing I would like to say, thanks to GVL for he has not said Supreme Court and High Court also as a holding up the black money or anti-national. The way if same thing was told by us, he would have simply branded us. What Supreme Court and Calcutta High Court has said today, it is just merely a reflection of the common man. How it feels pity and painful, how they are cut up with the reality. Mr. Prafulla was preaching that everybody should be happy with the responsibility in the responsible way, including Supreme Court. What Supreme Court says, same thing has been told by us. And you remember, Niranjan, half the panel were the same. day before or 2 days earlier to the parliament started, I had raised few questions, like the farmers should be allowed, the people who are getting married in their house, they should be allowed.
No, we've spoken about that.
I mean, they started doing the lip service.
Rajiv, we've spoken about that. No, we've spoken about that.
Now you are seeing that. Whole day on the TV channel. I'll give you an example. Myself, I had urgent work. Okay. I signed a check for 24,000.
Okay.
Went and stood in the queue in the bank, and I was given only 6,000 rupees. You just for the media.
Yeah, if it's an urgent issue, coming back to the question I asked you, Rajiv Rai, I want to bring in Waris Pathania. Waris, if the issue is that serious, like Rajiv Rai said, everybody, in fact, let's accept it. Each of the panelists here have had personal experiences when it comes to either exchanging money or having cash in hand, right? Everyone has had issues either standing in a line or being able to get the new currency. We're not in denial about that. But if the issue is serious, my limited point on this debate is, why should the absence of the Prime Minister be any basis to prevent a debate? That's all I'm asking. If the issue is serious, why shouldn't the opposition should and the Prime, specifically the Congress
the
party let the debate go
present
through?
In the parliament when the debate is taking place?
Again, you're coming back to the same point. What did I ask you?
Why,
if the issue is serious, why can't you debate it without the Prime Minister in the House?
Let me tell you one thing, Niranjan. The Supreme Court has made certain observations after seeing the entire problem faced by the country. 55 people have died due to the denominatization of the notes. Now, why? Who is going to take the responsibility
not only
of the
because
people
of
who are
this,
dying?
A lot of deaths are attributed
further?
To
the
this.
The situation is going from bad to worse.
I think
the Prime Minister must come in the Parliament and enter into the debate. The Parliament must answer to the nation. The Prime Minister must say
Waris Pathan, and what we are saying is that the politicians, the MPs are collectively failing in doing that, Waris Pathan. Why is it that people have to go to the courts time and again for every important issue? Any important legislation, Waris Pathan, the people have to turn towards the courts.
Where
because the political parties
the,
are failing in our parliament. Now, G.V. Narasimha very quickly responding to what Waris Pathan has to say, then we have to wrap up this debate. But do you think that all political parties and the MPs have collectively failed to take the debate inside the houses in a constructive manner? Else, why would anybody have to turn towards the courtrooms? The decision has been taken, G.V. Narasimha Rao. Would your government and your party maybe reach out to the opposition and say, come, let's resolve this together for the larger interests of the country?
Thanvi.
Yes.
No, Thanvi, you see, any citizen of this country can go to the court.
Take back the decision.
Any citizen can go. I think that's not going to happen. Don't waste time on this debate.
Yeah, Waris, I think that has been made clear.
Any citizen can go to the court
of debate?
Law.
Then why are you calling about the debate?
Petition.
Come on, now my
there
question
is
then why do
really,
you ask for debate?
There is
when
no one can be barred from it. As far
happen.
As parliament debate is
Waris,
concerned,
don't your mind.
I think the
Waris,
government was sincere, has allowed a debate on this from
Waris,
day one. It's the opposition which has run away. Opposition does not know what to debate. They simply want to indulge in antics and dramatics. So as a result, you have the situation. But government is not
is
really waiting for the opposition. Government is doing its job 24/7. Government is reviewing the situation round the clock and taking up measures to improve the situation.
GVL.
To ease the situation.
Yeah,
it's
GVL.
A response
decisions
to government.
In 9 days.
What
yeah, GVL.
Expect?
Government running short of time. Decision in 9
GVL.
Days.
GVL, running short of time. Waris Pathan, please, you know, when you come to a debate, please have your line of argument clear. In the beginning, you said you are for cleanup of black money.
My
now you're saying you want
time.
A rollback.
No,
you
no.
said implementation was wrong. Now you're saying
right.
rollback the entire demonetization.
No.
Please, I don't have time. I have to end this debate at this point. Waris, only because I'm short of time. Only because I'm short of time, I have to end this debate at this point. But thank you to all our panelists. But very important to see what happens next. On one hand, is the government adamant on apology from Ghulam Nabi Azam, the Congress party, just to sort of buy more time? And is the Congress party sticking to the Prime Minister's presence in Parliament only to delay and stretch this debate? In fact, those two relevant questions, we will have to wait and watch how the Parliament session progresses, the winter session on Monday. But thank you for joining us on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.
Thank you.